welcome everyone to an exciting broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports. Some great action in store tonight, seeing some of the best and brightest young players on the hardwood. It's the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets taking on the Kansas Jayhawks.
And there's nothing better than college hoops, if you ask me. Where else can you hear the roar of the student section in a tightly packed building like this one? Always great to feel the energy of the campus.
And you know, Greg, this is where it all begins for a lot of these players. The experiences they'll have, the teaching they'll receive in the game of basketball. I don't think there's any substitute for going through a college season and dealing with the adversity, the highs and lows, and learning how to play basketball at this high level. These kids certainly will be the stars of tomorrow.
Taking a look at the Yellow Jackets, Ellis is out there with Jones, and there's Flash, and it's Smith, and it's Crawford at the shooting guard position.
Well, with his size and the way Prez remains calm and composed around the basket, it's easy to see why so many have him listed as the top big man of this class.
Yeah, and what is really attractive is just how high the ceiling is on Prez. He already has smooth go-to moves in the post, stuff you usually don't see until several years into one's pro career. And as you said, this kid just has everything working for him on the court.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
So he hits one of two from the stripe. Now here's Prez, guarded closely. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Man, I like to see Prez get aggressive inside. Really determined to score when he gets that close to the rim.
Here's Flash. Ellis outside. And it's Smith that time on the assist by Ellis. Smith's got his first points in this one.
And that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball in that position.
Over to the left wing. Back to Duncan. Now here's Prez. He's guarded by Ellis.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
Lee's checked in for the Jayhawks. Taylor's checked in for the Yellow Jackets. Lee kicks to Prez. And that one drops for him.
I'll tell you what, it's not easy being tagged the top high school prospect as Prez was early on for his class. But you have to give him credit for taking the honor in stride and keeping his feet on the ground while his head was in the sky.
Yeah, and I think what keeps Prez grounded about being that top recruit is that he knows it means nothing if he doesn't continue to grow and perform at the next level. A lot of players will think they've made it when they get that accolade, but Prez knows it's just the beginning.
No question he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
The Jayhawks shooting their first free throw. First trip to the line in this one. And the Jayhawks making a change here. Terry's checked in, and Georgia Tech also making a switch. Knight's checked in, and the call will be against Prez. That's his first foul. Taylor against Terry. Here's Smith. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that.
Yeah, up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Pulls up, high post. Hits the front of the rim and out. Yellow Jackets leading by four. Taking a look at the Yellow Jackets. They've got Jones. Taylor is out there with Smith. And there's Flash. And it's Knight in at the two. Here's Flash. Yellow Jackets moving the ball around. No good on the three.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Lee passes to Prez. From 13, he can't get it to go. Smith with the defensive effort.
Really tough time early for Prez as he just can't gather any sort of momentum in this game. Having a tough time gaining any traction out there.
And he's allowed to have a down game every so often, but with the importance of this matchup, you just wonder if the pressure is just getting to him a little bit out there. Might be trying to force things and do too much.
Terry dishes to Prez. Hits it from three-point range. Prez has got 7 points.
And this is what happens when you don't crowd Prez. Give him just a little daylight from the perimeter, and he makes it look easy.
Shot from the low block. Pass to Flash. 1:33 left here in the first half. Up top, Knight. Smith right side, over Prez, and it's Smith that time on the assist by Knight. And that's now 6 points for Smith.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
Terry kicks to Lee, pass to Prez. The 11-footer, and yes, it's good. He's got 9.
And really can't fault the D there. Prez just torching them with better offense.
And the Yellow Jackets decide to take their first time out here. A platoon swap here for Kansas. And the second half of basketball is about to get underway, folks. Welcome back to this broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports.
And, you know, this one has been a tight game all the way. Some runs made from both sides, but neither team has been able to hold a big lead for any lengthy period of time.
And I think we'll see things come to a head here in the second half. The teams that came out a little nervous early on, but guys like Prez will start looking to score more often, and this game will be decided by the stars on each side.
Prez, he's in at the 4 spot. Duncan is out there with Alabaster, and it's Calderon in at the 3 spot. And for Georgia Tech, Ellis is out there with Smith. Then it's Jones, and there's Flash, and it's Crawford at the 2.
And you can sense that the pressure might have gotten to him a little bit, but he did do enough to put them in the lead.
And one reason why Prez jumped to the top of the prospect list is because he had a great coach during high school. Coach Washington Falls gave him incredibly sound fundamentals, and it's allowed Prez to have a strong base with how he plays.
And not only did Coach Falls help him with his foundation as a player, but he also provided tremendous insight and advice into the world of basketball and the world that's around us in basketball. So I think Prez owes an awful lot to Coach Falls for the player he's become.
Lee's checked in for the Jayhawks. And Georgia Tech also making a switch. Taylor's checked in for Ellis.
And they start the second half with 3 straight misses.
Prez with the ball. Taylor's there. The lead. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Well, looking at the numbers for Prez in this one, 9 points, and he's chalked up 1 3-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
And the Jayhawks making a change here. Terry's checked in.
They should be in front right now, but he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty there.
And the call will be against Prez. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. Knight's checked in for the Yellow Jackets. Here's Flash. The feed now to Knight. Smith with a screen on Duncan. A nice shot by Knight. And Georgia Tech leads by 2.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Now here's Prez. 10 points for him. Here's Terry, ejected by Taylor. Here's Flash. They set the pick. It's stolen by Prez. Lee goes in, and the shot goes in. Lee's got it all tied up now for the Jayhawks.
And finally, they fought themselves back to even the score. We've got a new ball game here now.
And really, all the momentum is theirs, making such a strong comeback. So I think you've got to really feel good about their chances the rest of the way.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. And it's good off the back rim and in. Prez has got 12 in the game.
And you got to admire the attitude of Prez, staying with his shot despite the D being all over.
And the Yellow Jackets call time here. And as the coaches go to the clipboard, both teams will make substitutions. Prez in at power forward. Alabaster is out there with Duncan. And it's Gaines in at the center position. To the middle. Tipped away. Prez with the ball to take the lead. Gaines the pass to Prez.
And it's easy to admire Prez, a gifted player with a tremendous drive to be as good as he could possibly be.
So the first one drops, and that gives them the lead. And the Yellow Jackets with some changes. Smith comes in for Wright, and Jones subbed in for Jefferson. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in.
A lot of times you'll see a star player out of high school come in and only look to score when they get the ball. Prez is different in that regard. He knows the value of strong team play and is always willing to put the team first.
And, Greg, we've seen a number of players that say they have a team-first mentality, but the old saying is true, actions speak louder than words. From what I understand about Prez, he'll demand a lot of his teammates, and as far as mental focus, he won't let them slide at all.
Here's the dish to Prez. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
Boy, love how Prez owns these possessions, dominating the defense thanks to that tremendous confidence he plays with.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Jayhawks.
A lot of times when they needed some easy points in this game, they've been able to get to the foul line and get them.
They've also been pounding it inside tonight and coming away with a lot of points in the paint. I call those PIPs.
Now, here is Smith. In the corner, it's Crawford. Yellow Jackets moving the ball around. Down to five on the shot clock. On deep. Flash misses. And here's Calderon. He feeds it to Alabaster. Here's Gaines. Sinks it.
Those are huge points.
Beyond huge, partner. I mean, they needed that bucket desperately.
And the Yellow Jackets call time here. They're losing by four. 36 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Feeds to Smith. 26 seconds left here in the second half of the game.
And a lot of scoring here late, but there hasn't been any defense to speak of.
No, there really hasn't been, Greg, but that doesn't mean we haven't liked it. I mean, the highlight reel is being overwhelmed and overworked.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
That's right. No other option but to foul and put some misses.
Yeah, they have to extend the game. I mean, plain and simple. Use every second you can on the clock here.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. And it's a 3-point game.
Absolutely massive free throw. That'll force them into a 3-point attempt.
A 3-pointer would be huge right now.
Boy, a chance to tie it up with the game on the line. This is what we live for. I want to see what happens right here. And their solid play in the paint continues, guys.
And that's been their focus, it seems, throughout the game. I like the discipline that they've showed in terms of creating those opportunities on the inside.
He drops the first one, and he can gather himself now and try to make it 2 in a row. So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game. And the Yellow Jackets call time here. They're trailing by three. 15 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Guys, what do you think?
And there's still time left, so they don't necessarily have to go for the three. A quick, easy bucket inside will do.
Well, I think the clock's a little short here for that. I mean, I'm not quite sold on the quick two. I think they've got to look for a quality three to try to tie this thing up based on where the clock is right now.
Time expires, and we're going to overtime. Got more college basketball in store as we get ready now for overtime. What energy, what excitement in the building, folks, tonight. If you're just joining us, this is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, as we'll no doubt have some more exciting action to see who can get it done here tonight. And so in the game for the Jayhawks, Prez, he's in a power forward. Duncan is out there with Alabaster, and it's Diallo in at the pivot spot manning the middle.
Yeah, beautiful play on the interior. They're just using the height advantage to lay the ball up and in when they really needed that basket.
Out of bounds, it'll be the Yellow Jackets ball.
And what a time to get sloppy. A close game like this, you cannot be getting loose with the ball.
Kicks it to Smith. And there's the pass to Flash. Back to Smith. Rebounded by the Jayhawks.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Calderon kicks to Prez. On the high post. Connects! He has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
And that's how you shoot it from mid-range. Prez just nailing the shot with ease.
Passes it to Smith. Puts it up from 15. Smith missing again.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
When you talk about Prez, one thing that I think you need to keep in mind is that he epitomizes what it means to be a student athlete. I mean, never take shortcuts in the classroom, and is a very dedicated student off the court. Love to see that.
Yeah, and just talking to Prez for a few minutes, and you'll see how seriously he takes his academics, not just for himself, but for everyone in his life. And the fact he values that, that education speaks also, I believe, to his character.
And the Jayhawks making a change here. Gaines has checked in. Ellis, left side. Yellow Jackets moving the ball around. Here's Flash. He kicks it to Smith. Shot from the wing. The putback. Here's Ellis, and so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, free throws are always better than a layup, so I'd agree with you there, Greg.
And he cannot convert on the second. That misses. And now they decide to foul intentionally. That's the first. That makes it a three-point lead. And so both free throws are good. It's a four-point ball game.
That ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those freebies.
And the Yellow Jackets call time here. They're losing by four. We've got 13 seconds left in overtime. Outside, Jones. They set the pick. Let's the three fly, but they get it back. And so the Jayhawks take the win. They had to scrape and claw to push it to overtime, but they really came on in the extra period.
What a ride. I mean, I thought it might end in regulation, but you know what? They came through big and did exactly what was necessary once we got into OT.
For Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for joining us.